Ambassador Kenichiro Sasae, he's a former ambassador to the United States, as you know, who just completed his 6 years of tenure in Washington this summer. He now heads a think tank, Japan Institute for International Affairs, and actually just returned this morning from his business trip to India. Also an active contributor
about the discussions, and I find my local classroom people are talking all the time. So it's quite really my issue, but we need to put this issue kind of perspective. One is in this year, I mean, in the history of the United States, we all know. What happened
actually think that the rise of populist nationalist sentiment is reshaping politics in pretty fundamental ways in much, if not most, of the democratic world. So if you look in Europe,
that it's really
deepening, as Ian said earlier, the deepening of the GZERO world. I think a lot of people believe that, that the answer to this is sort of restoring the status quo ante. And there's a lot of talk about saving the liberal world order. And I think that's the wrong way to think about it. I think that, that the task is harder, but I think the task is to recreate a politics.
Thank you.
consumer limited set of conclusions from the Mueller investigation, he will be less vulnerable to impeachment. Impeachment in the U.S. is a two-stage process. The House of Representatives votes on a simple majority. If the Democrats take the House of Representatives, they will have the ability to set a bill, send a bill of impeachment to the Senate. But in the Senate, it's a two-thirds vote. That will mean that under the best circumstances for the Democrats, they're going to need at least 15 Republican votes to impeach the president, and they're not going to get them. And so for Trump, his election campaign is all about preempting the possibility of impeachment. That may come at some political cost to the Republicans, although aftermath of the Kavanaugh fight for confirmation. Even though Kavanaugh himself, his personal numbers have gone way down, I think the Republican base has been more motivated here than has the Democratic base, and at least some elements of the potential Democratic constituency, particularly independents and suburban women have been turned off by Democrats' strategies and tactics during the Kavanaugh fight. So, where is this going? Right now, it looks as if the Republican hold on the Senate is now secure. So, the Democrats had hopes of taking the Senate. Those look to be non-achievable at this point. It is still likely that the Democrats will take the House of Representatives, although the polling number is getting closer there, and I think people are looking at much, much less of a so-called wave election than they expected. I believe that in the context of Democrats taking the House of Representatives, that the political pressures after the Mueller investigation issue report, which is likely sometime in the early months of next year, I think the political pressures from the Democratic base are going to be extraordinarily difficult to contain. And I think the president wants the House to impeach him. If the Democrats take the House, the president wants impeachment. He believes that impeachment sets himself here on implications. And I agree with Ambassador Sasae on, I think the all of the talk about inevitable conflicts, commercial conflicts between U.S. and China has been exaggerated. Part of Trump's strategy in the midterms is to come across as being very, very aggressive towards China. I think after the midterm, he will shift on that. The timing of the G20 meeting in Argentina several weeks after the election is going to be perfect. I suspect there that we'll get at least some kind of a partial and temporary meeting of the minds between Xi Jinping and President Trump that will at least for the time being defuse some of these threats. So I think the most likely immediate implication is positive for U.S.-China, and the result of the election will be, I think, Trump achieving his goal of really tightening his control on the Republican Party. So we're now seeing the Republican Party move sharply to the right. The Democrats are moving sharply to the left, so I do think this issue of the center not holding has become a very real one for the United States.
So you sound like
Democrats overplayed their hand in the Kavanaugh case, turned off a lot.
Well, what David said is sort of a general common sense around Washington, D.C. these days. But the common sense sometimes gets wrong. When we had the presidential election last time, most of them were wrong, including some analysts and so forth. So I don't think that you would be wrong. Well, this time, that could be wrong. These days, you can't really predict what the America is all about, fight is headed for. So I think you have to take some margin out of all this general sort of common sense. Number two is that impact of this possible impeachment of the Supreme Court, the Kavanaugh case, is going to hurt President Donald Trump. In the short run, I think President, this is my theory, my own view. I'm not a private person, I'm an ambassador in the short life of space. It is obvious that, limits in white women supporting the president might not appreciate it. But when it comes to how they vote for the election, if there isn't any sort of a good candidate in the district, I mean, they don't vote. They don't vote necessarily whether the person is a Republican or a Democrat anymore. They tend to choose by characters of individual attraction rather than the traditional party affiliations. And I think the consensus view is partly Democrats would try, if they would win the majority in the House for the impeachment, even if the FBI is not really coming out with a solid evidence per se. All this debate about the current fitness and so forth, they could argue and try to give the damage to the president. I think, as you said, the president is he's a very good at fighting out, make this as an enemy to his base. And you continue to run on his base and move on. So the president is playing pretty strong, even including this midterm elections. And what about the Democrats? You are a Democrat, right?
I'm a Republican.
Oh, sorry. Democrats, the problem is that they haven't found any solution of this device, especially if they have some strategy to win back all this Trump base in the Midwest, and in the White. How Democrats would win all this vote, we haven't seen that. And then I first went to Washington a couple of weeks ago. People were talking about the path in the Midwest. There'll be more in the Democratic governors to be chosen this time. And so within 2 years, that impact of newly emerging Democratic governors might have some impact on the voting behavior in the West. If there is one, very much contrast to the president in many ways, might be a Democratic pickup for the president candidate. Then I think, hopefully, that will be completely well with the president. Otherwise, I think the Democratic Party continues.
country that all my life, I live in a kind of background. That was
right, that he can out-politic presidential level, it is being taken up by three elderly politicians. So Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, and the former Vice President Joe Biden. And maybe one of those will be able to defeat Trump. I'm a little dubious. I'm the only one who would have a chance to be Biden. But where's the new blood, and will the Democrats be able to rally around a governor like that Ambassador Sasae's point about governor is very important. That's been the winning Democratic formula most of the time in the past half century, has been the governor. Now, Obama wasn't expected to do that. Will there be a governor who comes out and is able to articulate something that will support it? Right now, I had a handicap in the very early going, the 2020 election. I think that it's still President Trump would be the favorite in this.
A lot of laws and the systems they have.
himself has been using the China issue as part of his electoral strategy, and he will seek a deal, and I think Xi Jinping absolutely needs a deal. So I do think there will be some kind of deal. It won't be comprehensive.
Thank you.
Trump. The others say Japan should fight to protect the liberal democratic order. Some people see Japan in trouble in the era of America First because Japan is a key ally in the United States. Others see Japan as a uniquely stable country in this GZERO world without the rights in populism. So what should we make of this all? And how Japan should navigate through this complex environment?
I think it's a long question to say that. We have seen this before back in the 1970s or even the 80s. We are always talking about the digit deficit and possibility of inflation and so forth. But the way the United States is doing to use all these taxes is very country doing this. What the United States is trying to do to get more economic sound laws.
Thank you.
Iranian